All right, would you rather have $70,000 cold hard cash, or would you rather have $700,000 worth of pennies? It's not a trick question. I'm not trying to trick you, but just, at face value, which one would you rather have? Pennies are unwrapped. They're not in the coin things. It's just they're going to dump a big-ass pile on wherever you want, in your backyard or whatever. Big-ass pile of pennies. And for reference, this is about 70 tons worth of pennies.
Ralph about to get mad now.
Actually, no, I think it's over 100 tons. It's over 100 tons worth of pennies.
You about to get mad.
At this point, I don't give a fuck because I'm already making my choice. I've already made my life.
Yeah, they already got this, so I'm really asking for you, and then we're going to dive in.
That's why I haven't said shit.
Yeah, we're gonna
dive in. That's why I'm staying quiet until Mirage gives his answer, so he can talk his bullshit. And then if he says the wrong thing, I'm gonna get it on his ass.
What do you think he picked?
I don't know what he picked, but I'm going with the pennies.
You're going pennies? All right, I'm in the minority here.
No, but let me tell you this about the pennies. I'm gonna have it somewhere. All these pennies, right?
Yeah.
I'm gonna just scoop up a whole bunch. Go to Jewel. Go to that Coinstar. Dump that shit in there. Cash a check every week.
That's what you said, right?
Yeah.
That's all you gotta do.
Put it in a big drum bucket. You know those metal drums. Put a shit ton of pennies in there. Go to the bank.
Or go to the bank or whatever.
But my thing,
you could literally sift through some of them. Maybe you get a rare one in there.
I mean, that's also true. But
I mean,
money
off that shit.
Do I have
the time to go through all that though?
I mean,
that's why I was against it, because the Coinstars break very easily.
At that point, you're not enjoying your $700,000.
This is labor now.
Your whole life is looking for that coin.
This is labor intensive.
Yeah.
Well, I mean,
you're going to go for the 70K cash?
Give me the 70K. I don't want this to be a job. This is a job now.
It's not.
Cashing pennies is a job now for me.
But it's $700,000. Like, bare minimum. Bare minimum, you're going to get $700,000. But the maximum could be a lot larger if you want it to be larger. So say you didn't want to do all that bullshit, sift through all those coins to see which ones are actually valuable. You're like, fuck it, I just want the money. Like, you could do that. It just takes a little bit more time, but you'll eventually still get there with a lot more money. Whereas if you still want to make a lot more money, you could just find those little coins.
Yeah. Now, okay, so I get... Okay, obviously, I understand. $700,000 is way more than $70,000. But I get embarrassed very easily. So going every day to this Coinstar and breaking their machine every other day... Because it's a scene. When you've been to a Coinstar and seen somebody with a bunch of coins, it's a scene. And then you break their machine, they're going to tell you to stop coming. I've seen videos where people are, cashing in regular amounts of coins, and they're breaking the Coinstar, and the owner of it is like, yo, I have to keep paying maintenance to fix the Coinstar because it keeps jamming.
I think it's
because
there's, random shit going in there, too. But if we just got the straight pennies...
It can't handle... It's breaking from random shit, but it's also because it can't handle that sheer amount of coins that you're putting in.
But there's other ways of, outside of Coinstar to count those coins. Because some people just do it by weight. So, because again, most coins are standard. They won't change that much in weight. And so, if you start piling them up and counting them by weight, you'll have a much easier time.
But who takes them is my only question. I'm not saying that they don't. Who takes them? But just in my personal opinion, I told them at the gym.
No one takes the whole 700,000 in one go.
No, they're not. I'm saying in large quantities though. But I've been to Walmart. I guess I told them I was down bad. I had some quarters. I was like, let me cash in these quarters. I went in Walmart I went in Chase and they gave me a booklet and was like, yo, press the quarters into the booklet and then we'll cash you out based on how much you got. So I don't know what bank will do that for you. I'm pretty I agree. That's how you measure large quantities of coins is by weight.
If you would call and be like, hey, I got this X amount of money, I want to deposit it, you think you can help me out? I feel like if you have them be prepared, that knowing that there's going to be a bunch of bullshit coming in that day, they're more likely to take it. If you were going I'm just going to go to Chase on a random Tuesday and be like, I want to cash all this shit out.
I mean, what are those armored trucks that move around money? Can't you be like, hey, I got the X amount of money.
Keep I don't know if pick you can use Garda for something like that. You might be able
but
to.
But I think the best case scenario for me to get that money taken care of.
But with Garda, still have to count the money yourself before you turn it in.
I mean, 700.
Because they ask you when they come.
I mean, for 700K, I could put someone on payroll to start rolling those pennies.
then you're losing money out. On Coinstar is taking a large chunk.
I'll still have more than 70K.
Coinstar takes a big percentage.
You can clearly use 10K, you still have 700K.
Yeah, it's way more than 70. More
no, it's
than
a percent.
You would have with the 70K.
I think Coinstar takes a huge percent.
Okay, but it's still going to be more than Coinstar 70K.
But the thing is, you go to a credit union, they got those machines, they won't take as much.
But that's a lot. But okay, I will give y'all this. The only way I can see, like, actually being able to cash it in a reasonable manner is if, can you, like, go to, like, I don't know, like, the Treasury or something like that? Like is there some government building where you can do it? I think a government building and not a bank, because they're in the business to make money at a bank. So they aren't here to be sifting through hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of coins, especially pennies, because nobody wants pennies anymore. People are trying to get rid of pennies. They've talked about making the penny obsolete.
I don't think the Federal Reserve would be able to do that for you.
We should be like Canada. Huh? And just take the pennies away like Canada.
Imagine they take the pennies away and they don't accept your cash. You have $700,000 of pennies and they're like, yeah, the penny doesn't exist anymore. We can't accept it.
Just start melting them down for the copper.
Absolutely.
Copper and zinc.
I think y'all are probably right. The $700,000, but that sounds like a lot of fucking work for me. A lot of fucking work. All right, well, there is one more, though. The other one that we were fucking going back and forth with was the...